Oh my God, it's such a dark day here in Denmark today, so I had to have my ring light on. Actually, I haven't used it since winter time. So yes, my video today is all about how to get your curls when they are gray a little bit not so rough and much smoother. I have questions about that because, as you know, I have natural curls, and since I have gone gray, it's been a lot more. And it's not due to that you're doing too many things with your hair. We can actually see that now when we are going gray. In my back, I don't know if you can see it because it's real, but I haven't done something to this for years. And the grays, let me see if you can see. They are just so curly like this. And also this. Normally I just use it with my hair dryer and I take these curls off. But I also have days where I said to myself, now you have to just let it dry off itself, so it will not be so damaged or very not a light structure, if you can say that. I use, when I have days where I have all my natural curls, I use this Cantu Coil Calm Detangler, and it's for curly hair. And I just put some spray of that when I come out of the bath and I have toweled my hair dry. And then I just let it dry, and this is the result. I have curls, and my hair is very, I don't know what you call it, but up here is my grays, down here. Down here in the back, and they're not as smooth as you think. That now that you don't color your hair, it will be all smooth. No, not if you have curl hair like I do and many others. I had some viewer asking me if not asking me, have the comment that she thinks gray hair only looks good on flat hair and less curl hair, and I said no, absolutely not. I follow a group on Facebook, I think it's called Curly Silver, and there are many, many gorgeous women there with curl. I actually think it could be a plus because you can hide the gray transition a lot more if you have curls. You just do this, and yeah, there's up here, and there's down here, and here. But it's much more covered, I think, so it can be a plus. Also, I just sometimes wear it like this, put a little clip in, or I curl it to the side, do like this, and then a clip in here. So yeah, there's a lot of possibilities when you have curled hair. And actually, I can have it both because my curls is most when I came out of the shower and let it dry. And also, I have a lot of I don't know what you call it. I will set it in here. But one thing I use for my dry hair in my shampoo, I drop a few drops of glycerin. 100% natural glycerin. So this is not the chemical glycerin, this is all natural. Because when you have dry hair and you have very unstructured hair, it's not because your hair is damaged, it's actually because it needs so much moisture. Because even when you go out, you can have all those curls doing if it's a little. It had rain and so on. It gets very, very curly and frizzy, soaking all the water in. So it needs hydration, and therefore glycerin is very, very good. Also, when you buy a shampoo, look at the ingredients. See if glycerin is very high on. Normally, it can be water, sulfate, everything, but glycerin has to be up in the front to give your hair moisture. What I also need, now we're talking a little of purple shampoo, because purple shampoo, it will also dry your hair. I have used many purple shampoo in my gray hair transition, and some are good, some are not so good. The thing is with purple shampoo that it actually not does do your hair gray. It's only if you have gray hair or your hair is bleached, it can be silver, but it has to be bleached. So it's a little about purple shampoo, but if I have to use one, I use this. This is the Bold and Unique. You can get this from Amazon. It's a very popular purple shampoo. If you seek on Instagram on Bold Unique, you will see a lot of women that are very stunning and have used this, both silvers and also bleached hair, younger women. It has stunning results. So go look up on Instagram about this. Also, many YouTube videos about Bold Unique. I use it, but since I'm not bleached, it only gives me a little of those silver down here, so the demarcation line is not so rough. Also, when you come out of the shower, as I have just been, don't do this with a towel. Now I've done it, but you only do like this. Dab it. Just tap it like this. And it will not do so much harm to your hair when you do it like this. If you do, it do damage to your hair. Also, when I came out of the shower, I'd use this comb, and it's very good because it can actually comb through the curls and it does not harm your hair as it will do with a brush. So it's very good. Also, one tip is I showed you this before, it's the Gliss Schwarzkopf Daily Oil Elixir, and it's absolutely amazing. I just put a few drops in and then I warm it up with my hands. And I just put it down here in the curls. Now my hair is still wet because I came out of the shower, but and also a little bit in here, and it just give a more lightness and a shine. I love it very much. So that was my tips for a curly gray hair, which I actually think can look very stunning and can be a plus. Also, when I edited this video, there was a question and a comment about someone tried my eyelash serum and my tips for long eyelashes. I will link my video up here if you haven't seen it already. The comment was that she already has some progress with it, and I'm very, very happy to hear about that. So, but she also says she have a rough time getting her mascara off and therefore can lose some eyelashes. So what I use, many times I have many, many mascaras, but I use this Milanese, and it's coating your lashes, but you can take it off with water, 38 degrees. So what you do instead of doing like this, woo, you just put warm water up and you can take off the mascara with your fingers. And that is very good because it does not harm the lashes so much. Also, if I haven't ju have just an ordinary mascara on, I just use an organic circle face wash 3-in-1. It's absolutely amazing to take your mascara off. But I'm very, very happy to hear that someone has progress with my serum. And it's all only been 14 days since I published my video. But ladies, that was my tips for curly gray hair.
Little bonus tips for your curly gray hair. I bought this hairband the other day and I am so happy about it. It goes so well in with your normal hair color and all the new grays popping up. And I think it's amazing because it gives some character to the hair because it has those, up here. And it covers the demarcation line a lot. I also use it just when I have flat hair,
I
and
think
every woman in their gray hair transition will have gain out of such a hairband. But that was a little bonus tip.